Welcome back to Investor Intel at PDAC 2018. I'm joined today by Greg Andrews, who is the CEO of Search Minerals. Greg, you're in rare earths in Newfoundland, so I'm going to start with this. What's happening in the rare earths market?
In the rare earth markets, we're excited again because the interest is starting to come back. We're in an increasing trending market with the, especially electrification of vehicles is leading it, and the permanent magnet space is what we're really in with our key components of our rare earth deposit would fuel that industry of the permanent magnets.
North America is basically out of the rare earth business. Do you guys think you can change that?
Absolutely. Every day that we wake up, we're looking to see how we can get to our bankable feasibility study. Yesterday, we wanted to drill our Deep Fox property that we released our assays results to confirm what we, the geological footprint that Foxtrot has. And Deep Fox was compelling because of the higher grades and bigger surface expression. So we're excited that we may have work towards two resources in our district concept, and that will help support that.
So you're in Newfoundland, but you're actually in Labrador, which may give people the impression of being somewhat remote, but that's not my impression.
No, one of our key things to in the rare earth space is to get the operating cost down, the capital cost down, and we're on great infrastructure. Where our mine, our Foxtrot deposit is 12 kilometers from a town of St. Louis, which already has a deep sea port for infrastructure. A road runs right through our property. We have power that we would just need to put in and move 12 kilometers down the road. Our Deep Fox project that we're just working on is 2 kilometers. So it's in close proximity that we're working in with that environment, with the environmental use and the infrastructure.
I've had a little bit of experience with it. How are you finding Newfoundland to work with?
Oh, it's fantastic. The support that we have from everybody, from the governments down. We're just starting our environmental impact statement process. So we're meeting with the Canadian CEAA and the province to get the baseline studies. We'll start with that. They work together cohesively as a team to make sure they want to see the projects through, through the proper environmental, which we're, you know, we will be transparent and work with all our stakeholders to get it there for our bankable feasibility that we'll need.
Good stuff. So investors have already seen great drill results this year. What else should we be watching for?
Well, the drilling was only 3 holes out of 500 meters out of 2,000. So we're looking to complete our 2,000. We'll start that in May and June. But if we have our positive results, we're looking to expand that to 4,000 meters and try to catch up Deep Fox with our Foxtrot resource and have two resources at the same level of PEA discussion. And that's really what we want to put forward of our development of our district to move it forward.
Well, anyone who's following the battery and the automotive electrification process really does understand the value of rare earths. So it's great to hear a positive rare earth story here in Canada in a great jurisdiction. So thank you very much, Greg. Appreciate the time.
Oh, thank you.